We have with us Mr. T.P. Oswal, tax expert, renowned tax expert, and member of UN Committee on Transfer Pricing, who's joining us straight from the UN Committee meeting in Geneva, which is discussing, among other things, some major new developments, a new FTS article and automatic information exchange, which is in focus at the 11th session of the UN Committee of Experts on International Cooperation in Tax Matters. I think the meeting got underway yesterday, and Alexander Trepelkov, Director of Financing for Development Office at UN, highlights that the Addis Ababa Action Agenda clearly recognizes that taxation and international tax cooperation are critical to financing sustainable development. Among the important items on the agenda at the current session involves work of 5 subcommittees on transfer pricing, extractive industries taxation issues for developing countries, tax treatment of services, exchange of information and negotiation of tax treaties, and of course, a new article on taxation of fees for technical and other services. That's going to be big. Without any waste of time, I'll hand it over to Mr. Oswal. Any update for us from Geneva, sir?
The agenda for the 11th session of the United Nations Tax Committee are very, very crucial and important. They are proposing to consider Article 1 and its applicability to the hybrid entities in a specific manner. Serious changes. Permanent establishment issues for connected projects is being changed, looking at what the OECD is doing. Sharing article will be discussed, but that has not been discussed. But the important agenda which were discussed were exchange of information, BEPS, and the technical services article.
Okay.
There will be a sea change in the model of the United Nations. From 2017, possibly you will find the services as a separate article.
You have 57 seconds.
To the tax treaties India has with number of countries in terms of definition. But there would be some exclusions like what we have in the USA tax treaty. The exclusions particularly teaching in and by the education institution, personal services, use of personal services, etc. It will be out from the fees for technical services.
Sir, if I could cut you, has there been a consensus on BEPS?
Well, there has been, this matter has been debated for last 3 years. And ultimately, the article has been drafted consensusly, and the consensus has been arrived at on article. Commentary consensus is yet to be developed. It's going on.
And what did Mr. Pascal Amans tell you all?
Pascal Amans' address was very thought-provoking in terms of the BEPS project, and now this is how the implementation will undertake, that we are working on it. BEPS project has already been completed in terms of their deliverables are concerned. But some aspects are still pending, particularly digital economy and multilateral instrument. They are working on it. Next month onward, they will be working seriously on it. But the major development in UN, UN members said that this is an agenda UN should pursue, because as what Philip Baker had said in your conference in Delhi, conclave in Delhi, that this should be a UN agenda, and the Philippines and a number of other countries have raised the issue. How can the 60 countries guide 193 countries? And therefore, this must be, and there should be a conference organized by the United Nations on implementation or working out developing country BEPS.
Yeah.
So therefore, you see the interesting developments are taking place. You can see the things are changing. Why the developing countries are getting attracted to OECD? Because they invite them free. And now they want to have their own concerns and voices.
Yeah. Can I ask you a couple of quick questions? So on revision of chapter on transfer pricing documentation, so is the UN committee considering country by country reporting?
Well, that matter has been left to the transfer pricing committee, and that we are debating, going to debate in the next meeting of our transfer pricing subcommittee in Chile in November 2015.
Yeah, but you know, over the last couple of years or last few years, there's always been a little bit of tension between the OECD and the UN. Now that the final BEPS reports are out, are you somewhere seeing a lot more coordination? You're seeing some better bonhomie between both of them? A little more convergence in thoughts?
There has been a talk about convergence, there has been a talk about bonhomie. There has to be cooperation among both the groups. But this will not happen. It's not that easy to happen because, you know, unequal clubs can never succeed. Like you have seen the experience in WTO. So similar things are going to happen. And I have my own doubts whether multilateral instrument, how they are going to draft, how they are going to... So possibly they will tone down the size of some of the articles of multilateral instrument, and this is on this there is a consensus, and therefore let us sign these agreements, come together, rest of all you can develop yourself.
Yeah.
It makes no sense. It is absolutely stupid. It is just for the sake of maintaining your ego and prestige, you will create one document which is a smaller article for few articles, but if you do not achieve the objective of coming out with a complete unanimity on 31 articles of the OECD model or UN model, then it is just ego issue, nothing else.
Yeah, last couple of questions, sir. Do you think the new article on fees for technical services could be a game changer with respect to the taxability of fees for technical other services? And what kind of services would fall under the ambit of other services, sir?
We know fees for technical services article is appearing in our treaties, and our experience in India is so vast on that. We don't have to say that the whole experience India has developed over a number of years now will trouble the whole world, because the fees for technical services, what can constitute technical services, even the UN group does not want to define. They say we have the three words, managerial, technical and consultancy. When the members ask the question, what is the technical in technical? You just explain, he says we will leave it to each member country to interpret. However, one thing which they have said is Article 14, any services covered by Article 14 will not be covered by Article 1 fees for technical services. And therefore, one respite is that professional services and the other services which are covered by Article 14 will get out of it.
Yeah. And last question, sir, what would be the impact on India? Because you are flying India's flag high at the UN, sir. What is going to be the impact on India of this UN meet?
Our new article, there will be major impact if other countries start withholding tax, and the other countries will make changes in their domestic law to have withholding tax to align themselves with the source rule principles of the OECD, and also aligning with the new principles of the technical services article of the United Nations. This is going to create a major havoc in terms of revenue loss. India is going to suffer because all payments in India will be subject to withholding in other countries.
Yeah, thank you, sir. I won't take much of your time. I know you have to rush back to a session. We touch base with you again tomorrow with Oswal.
You want to take Nilesh with you?
Yeah, if Nilesh is there, he could quickly summarize something in 20 seconds, sir.
Okay. Hi, Ravi.
Yeah, welcome Nilesh bhai. Mr. Nilesh Kapadia, who is also serving on the UN Committee for Transfer Pricing, and he is also with Mr. Oswal in Geneva. Sir, any thoughts you would want to add to what Mr. Oswal just said?
Currently, so far as services is concerned, we are going through the nitty-gritty of drafting the article. One draft was presented, it was revised twice. Now the final draft is expected to be presented tomorrow. So it seems that at the end of this week, one final agreed draft should be available, and which may be ready for adoption in the next update of the model.
Okay.
But as PP just mentioned, it is there is a lot of talk between the OECD members that while India pushing for this article, because India is a net exporter of services, and India will a lot to lose in terms of revenue if this article is implemented by all the other countries.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much, Oswal ji and Nilesh bhai, for talking to us. We'll touch base with you again tomorrow. Thank you so much and have a great day.
Okay.
Thank you.